Hi, I'm Alex with Splunk Education. In this video, we'll show you how to use lookup files to enrich your ingested data using the Splunk tutorial data files.
You may have noticed in our last video where we ingested the Splunk tutorial data, there were two files available for download, tutorialdata.zip and the prices.csv.zip file. The prices.csv.zip file contains product IDs, product names, regular prices, sale prices, and product codes. Splunk automatically interprets the first row or the column header in the CSV as the field names, and the subsequent rows as field values. This is called a lookup file, or sometimes referred to as lookup tables or lookup table files. With the tutorial lookup file, we can match the IDs in the Buttercup Games store events with the IDs in the lookup file. This will associate these other values in the row to the corresponding IDs. The IDs in our data do not tell us much about the products themselves. Being able to display the actual product names and bring in additional information like pricing details enables us to create more impactful reports and dashboards. This matching is referred to as field lookups. After the field lookups are configured, you can add any of the fields from the lookup file to your searches. Now that we know what lookup table files we are working with and what field lookups are, let's create some. First, we will download the prices.csv.zip file from the search tutorial page found at docs.splunk.com. Unlike the other tutorial data file, we will want to uncompress this one. Then we will log in to our Splunk test environment where we previously ingested the tutorial data. We navigate to the settings menu and select lookups. We are taken to the lookups management page where we can create new lookups or edit existing lookups. To use a lookup file, we must first upload the file to our environment. So we select Add New next to Lookup Table Files. First, we confirm or define the destination app, which specifies which app we'd like to upload the lookup table file to or where we plan on utilizing the lookup in our searches. Then under Upload a Lookup File, click Choose File and browse for the prices.csv we downloaded earlier. So we are able to follow along with the rest of the search tutorial online, we'll set the destination file name as prices.csv. This name is important because we will need it when creating the lookup definition. We click Save to upload the file. Now we can navigate back to the Lookups Management page and select Add New next to Lookup Definitions. Same as before, we'll need to confirm or define the destination app. Then we provide a name for the lookup definition. This name is used for knowledge object management. We leave the type as file-based, which typically means a static table, such as a CSV file. For the lookup file, we select the prices.csv, which we just uploaded moments ago. We leave the checkboxes for configure time-based lookup and advanced options unchecked and click Save. Under the lookup definition page, the supported fields column displays which fields are added by the lookup. We can also run a search to verify the lookup file. We pipe to the input lookup command, then specify the lookup table name that we set earlier. The input lookup command is a generating command, which means nothing will precede the pipe. We can see the column header values, which are our lookup fields, and field values in each subsequent row. To use these fields in search, we would write a query looking for the tutorial data. As a best practice, always include index and host source or source type in your search for more efficient results. Now we pipe to lookup, specify the lookup table file same as before, and use product ID as the input field, which is the field common in our events and our lookup file. Next, using the output clause, we define which fields we would like to include from the lookup. While the events look the same, on the field sidebar, we can see our new fields and even run a quick report with them. Let's go one step further and configure an automatic lookup, so all the fields from the lookup table are always available when we search the tutorial data. Navigating back to Settings, then Lookups, This time we select Automatic Lookups. For the destination app setting, we ensure it is set to search, like with the table file and lookup definition. Then we provide a name for knowledge object management purposes. Under Lookup Table, we select prices_lookup. All the other options we see are lookup table files that come with the product. Next, for Apply To, the value source type is already selected, and we set named to access_combined_wcookie, which is the source type assigned to the appropriate events from the tutorial data. For lookup input fields, we type product ID in both text boxes. The lookup input fields are the fields that the lookup table and the events have in common, just like when we used the lookup command in search. The lookup input fields are used to associate or link the fields from the lookup table file with fields in your events. The first text box specifies the field name in the lookup table file. The second text box specifies the field name in your events. For the lookup output fields, specify the names of the fields from the lookup table file that you want to add to your event data. You can specify different names here if you prefer. Just like above, in the first text box, we type the field name as it appears in the lookup table file. Then in the second box, we can specify the name of the field that will appear in our events. We select Add Another Field and complete this step for all fields, or however many we would like to include. Once complete, we leave Overwrite Field Values unchecked and click Save. We are taken to the Automatic Lookups page and confirm the automatic lookup we just configured is in the list. Now, if we navigate back to search and write a query looking for the tutorial data, the lookup fields show up automatically.
We hope you enjoyed this demo of how to enrich the Splunk tutorial data with lookups. Ready to take your skills to the next level? Head on over to STEP for more resources and learnings designed to help you master everything there is to know about lookups. Happy Splunking!